Oh, the Queen and Duke came over here to visit our great land, to open our new opera house, a celebration grand. There were lots of fancy speeches from the yes men and their push, but there was no mention of the food producers from the bush. No, the men beyond the black stump were not there. They were far too busy working to bother or to care. They were busy fighting gravel flood in lonely isolation. No, the men beyond the black stump were not in that celebration. There were interviews with questions and the answers well rehearsed, and pressmen fighting to jump on that old bandwagon first. And the Queen would grant a holiday if she should feel inclined, but the men who built the beef roads did not cease their daily grind. No, the men beyond the black stump cannot stop. They were busy with the shearing or harvesting the crop. They were mustering and branding on a distant cattle station. No, the men beyond the black stump were not in that celebration. There were women of society rigged out in latest gear, with the hope that in some magazine their picture may appear. But away beyond the black stump where the women work like men, oh, the opening of the opera house did not mean much to them. No, the women from the bush did not attend. They had kids to teach and meals to cook and clothes to wash and mend, while their menfolk worked the mineral mines for needs of other nations. No, the women from the black stump were not in that celebration. It's the people of the bush that keep this country on its feet, getting timber, beef and mineral, building roads through dust and heat. While the fencer rammed the strainer and the drover held the lead, old Sydney town made history with a most important deed. But the people from the black stump were not there, with the rules and regulations and polluted city air. Though the opening of that opera house was such a great occasion, oh, the folk beyond the black stump were not in that celebration. No, the folk beyond the black stump were not in that celebration.